Hello, everybody. Welcome to Pearls of Wisdom. We have a full moon today, so I'm going to do a full moon reading for you, and I will share my desktop now with you so you can see the chart. Now, here we have, again, it's a huge cluster of planets, not that concentrated anymore like before, but you can see the only opposite here on this side is the moon in Virgo, and we have the sun, and this is the third time we had a full moon before, a dark moon, and again a full moon in Pisces. Now, the sun, well, it takes 4 days to move into Aries, and this is when a big change will happen. So this will come in this moon phase here. Now let's look at the moon in Virgo. Remember, Virgo is the sign of harvest. When we have Taurus, is where you plant the seed in Virgo, you harvest, and it grows in the time between Taurus and Virgo till it declines in Capricorn is where it dies. So that's the absolute natural rhythm of things that are happening. We cannot go without death. It is very important that when something has grown and is going to the decline, it needs death to be make that something new can be reborn. So again, I think it's very important here to understand that Saturn is not just a bad guy. You know, we have a distinguish between polarity and duality. Now, what I'm working with here is polarity. Polarity is just yin and yang, is dark and light, it's the different elements, they're positive and negative, but not in the sense of good and bad. Duality is like on top, instead of writing, say, for example, yin and yang, there is good and bad. So duality is putting everything into good and bad category. Now, this is judgment, and this is what is leading us into destruction, in fact, and into illness, because we start to judge everything. We don't have to judge it. Things just are. They are the way they are, and you choose how you experience it. Now, when we have the moon in Virgo, that means that now on a soul level also, and this is why there is so much confusion in the moment also, because we harvest what we have created. We have created a lot of things in these past lifetimes that we've been here, and now we are faced with it. And the situation you are in will show you exactly the lesson that you have to understand in the moment. And this has nothing to do, again, neither good nor bad, it just is. And when we are going into judgment all the time, we are just making things much more difficult. Because here now Pisces, see, Pisces is still the part of the hidden. You cannot see what is. So the consciousness itself is still in the process of going through that last phase of this level to come back to a new level. When you look at the sign of Pisces, you have two moons. Actually, you can see it here. You have two moons, and then there is actually, it looks like a line, but it's a circle again to connect two moons. And this is the whole circle of the zodiac that is actually combined. So we have two moons, they connect. One is the old circle that finished here, and then you come into a new circle or cycle that starts at the end of Pisces. And the time in between is the transition, and that is compared also when we die, before we reincarnate again. You have a phase where you forget everything and prepare to come into this body. I have done a lot of regression therapy many years ago, and this is very clear there. You can see that people experience it also. Many tell it's like you go to sleep and then you wake up again when you come back as a human being. Now, in this last 4 degrees, the sun, it is the last undergoing of this sleep in a way, till the new awakening is happening. And we also have an opposition from the moon to Chiron, which helps you to heal. You know, sleep generally is very important for our body. The body is restoring its energies, it's healing, it's rejuvenating. If we don't have proper sleep, we are in deep trouble. Now, in a way, this is that time that we should be able to let go of all the old and get ready for something new to happen. Mercury is ahead here, already close to Uranus in Aries. So a lot of mental images are coming up already. Now you see that cluster here with all these planets here. We have also a couple karmic half squares here that show that we are not at ease or at peace yet with this process, which is also indicated when I look again. This is the world chart that I make for London, that here Venus and Mercury or Mars, sorry, Venus and Mars in Aquarius are also in 12th house. So we can see that everything is still kind of standing still and not yet ready to move. Even though a lot of things are happening already in the outside world, I see a lot of, I don't know if you have already heard that information about the lawyer Füllmich. That is a very good news that's happening. And a lot of things are preparing, but they are not out yet. They are not yet out in the open. So here we see the same Jupiter and Neptune. This is again Neptune 12th house, no? Neptune, the ruler of Pisces 12th house, just at the cusp. Jupiter is the planet that want to expand. We have the moon standing on the cross. This means going beyond everything what we've known before. After we have gone through the underworld, which is represented with Saturn here, we have also the cross on top and the moon hanging on the vertical level underneath the horizontal. That means the soul in the underworld. Now we are here rising into the higher consciousness, leaving these boundaries behind us. But again, as long as you hold on to the old paradigm, as long as people hold on to old ideas and are not ready to let go of the ways they have understood life before, things cannot happen. Now, this is the time that we manifest. You know, it's like when you put the seed into the soil, the seed has to die so the plant can start to come out. So we can see here, like as a symbol in this chart, that the seed is already in the ground. That's what you also can hear very often. It happened already. The breakthrough has happened already on a higher level, but not yet manifest in the material world. So the seed has already died, and the seed has already the little sprout coming out, but not yet above the surface. So it's still hidden. It's not above the surface yet. Now you can see here that people are, because of that, coming a lot of controversy information's coming out. And of course, what happened with the media in general, there is still a lot of fear-mongering. And that's, in a way, normal, because they want to press you again into a norm, A4, A5, to be normal, to be normed. But what we are supposed to be is natural. Natural, like who we really are, to be natural in our behavior, be back into nature to function how we are supposed to function. So here we see that there is still a difficult period coming here, but it's very soon breaking through, because Mercury will come to Uranus and the sun will move out in 4 days of Pisces into Aries. So hold on, get your seatbelt fastened. I think a lot of things will crash in the time when the sun is moving through Aries, moving with Mercury over Uranus. That will be explosions on many different levels. And I hope, I pray that it will not be very violent, but it depends on the behavior of the people. You know that we create our own reality. That's a very basic spiritual understanding. Has nothing to do with New Age. That is not really accurate, because New Age is also hijacked. So the true spiritual understanding is that we create our reality. So now, when everything has gone through Pisces, now we have ended the cycle. We have moved into something new already, but it's not completely manifest. And it's still, the manifestation still takes time, because the physical reality is always the last to catch up. We have first an idea, we process it, and then we manifest it. And this is the symbol of Mercury, if you remember I said that before, which is in fact the archetype of the human being. And if something you want to say, I am this or I am that, then you have to look where your Mercury is. This is the closest to what you behave. Your sun is your consciousness, and definitely does not tell you who you are. Now we have the yellow lines. The yellow lines are Venus aspect 72 degrees that are connected with creativity, with creation. So now see, this is why I said now you create. We have already started to create quite a while ago, but now there is another chance with this strong Venus aspect, and is actually coming from Venus. Venus here, this is aspect going to the node. So that is the humanity, the whole humanity has now a chance to shift into a different consciousness, to get rid of all that old stuff. This is what really, when you look at the sign of Aries, the sign of Aries is like a plant that comes through the soil, and you see very often the first thing that goes is a plant coming up like this. And this is now the breaking through moment where all, even concrete, is not strong enough to hold you back. And you know, concrete is something that we make artificial to plaster over nature, to hold nature down. But when you leave it for a long time, it has no substance. It will crack. Nature is always stronger. And this is what is happening now. Nature is stronger. And the goal, what you see here, we have the axis into Sagittarius, is the breakthrough. Jupiter here at AC with MC Sagittarius means that this breakthrough is happening now, even if we cannot see it yet. And I will go quickly to the chart of the time, what is here now in Thailand right now, but don't worry about that. And I just show you when we move forward. See here, we move forward. And now you can see the sun is here hitting Aries, and here at the same time Mercury is in a very close conjunction already with Uranus. It actually has 2 days ago, no, yes, 3 days from now is the exact conjunction. And then we move forward here with the sun into Aries. And you see here that we still have that aspect from Mars, that a very powerful new structure is already created, but will take place. So in what house that will happen, that depends in what area of the world that you live. Because every horoscope of a different place has a different house constellation, depending on the time, on the earth, in the moment where you live. And this is a very, very powerful movement when you can see here from the moon how all these aspects are unfolding. And we can also see here the tension that gives us a triangle. The moment when this is happening, when that breakthrough is happening, it will be for many people shocking because they still resist. When you don't resist, it will not be bad or horrible. But all the resistance, that energy of your resistance will just kind of push back to you or kind of like slam back into your face. So this is very important at the moment that maybe you can make an affirmation, like when you wake up in the morning, say, for example, spirit or God, goddess, or whatever you call it within. Don't give your power away to anything outside of you. You don't need to do that. You have the divine spark within you. Life is within you. Life is God. So I surrender to spirit within, to God within, to whatever you call it. And I ask to be guided. And I ask him or her to tell me what I need to know. Because then you really get the information that you need. If you ask questions, you might ask the wrong questions and you might not get answers to the situation that is happening. So if you give up, you give up your ideas, how things should be, your sorrow, your anxiety, you give it up, then you're, I call it upstairs team, can help you to solve the problem and give you the information that you need to know for the moment. And this is exactly important here now. Imagine, now we are stepping into a complete new energy. It has been here underneath, but it's coming up, 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 up. And now we are going through. This is a time we have waited for millennia, and it's happening now. So it is very important that we get ready for that. And please do not blame others for what happened to you. You have created this because this is the situation you need to learn from. We cannot move forward if we don't have those bad guys out there telling us, because very often it is the so-called enemies who really help us the most moving forward. Very often our friends, they are just trying to please us, but they don't tell you, for example, when you have a bad smile in your mouth, they don't tell you. And you suffer because of that. But an enemy might tell you, you stink out of your mouth. And then you can start to do something because then you know. So don't judge. Please don't judge. That's the worst you can do. And that is the thing that will hold you back to move forward. Judgment. Now, let go. Get into a meditation. And I think you can make a little ceremony, a ritual in this dark moon energy, which is always like 3 days, the day before the dark moon itself, and the day after until the new moon comes, when the first moon crescent is visible. So you can use that time to make a little ceremony and ask spirit to help you to see things in the right perspective. And once you can see very clearly what is happening in your life, then you will be able to change it. You cannot change something you don't know is there. So it is Neptune, Jupiter, and the AC we have here is like Neptune is still the mist, and you come through the boundaries and it's still not very clear. So you, ego, persona, cannot see yet what is happening. So you have to surrender. You have to surrender to that, what we can call higher self, whatever. Surrender to that divine to guide you, to help you, to give you this impulse that you do the right thing. You see, there is also a 1.5 square here to Mars. There is a lot of anger out there. And I see many information that come out are totally angry. Anger doesn't help. You remember that the game that is going on is fear, anger, fear, anger, fear, anger. That's going forth and back to keep you in a low consciousness level. So give it up. When you're angry, it does not help you. And also it just pulls you down and you give your power away again to somebody else to make you angry. So somebody else who is angry at you, that's this other person's problem, not yours. This is important to understand. So learn now again, visualize what you want, visualize the life, but don't, when you go into abundance topic, and the moon is also in the abundance topic with the harvest, don't look at the money. Money is not abundance. Money might be an aspect of abundance, but abundance is much more. Don't limit yourself to just put on a check or whatever, even gold bars. This is all, abundance is a consciousness. Once you understand that we have everything, that everything is here in abundance. If you look in nature, you become natural again. Like I have in the moment, fruits out there like crazy. I cannot even catch up anymore. I was having my whole dehydrator oven working day and night to get my bananas and my other fruits dried so I have it the whole year round. So this is important to understand. Abundance is natural. It is our nature. We just push it away if we go into the ego perception of lack, of there is not enough. And again, that's a program. So once you let that go, and once you say also, Spirit, I know there is abundance, even if I cannot understand it in the moment, but I want you to help me to understand, to guide me towards the abundance within me so I can manifest it without me. That's the same. Then the world will change. Everything will change. Remember, the situation we're in, humanity has created as a whole, has allowed the negative energies to take over. Now the time has come to shift, to change. Now we are moving in another timeline. But again, those who are not ready, they will move on in the lower timeline, where is the polarity more or less of anger and fear. So I wish for you for this full moon that you really can access that power and that energy, that you can have these 3 days of the full light of the moon to help you to see and understand what abundance really is and create it, so that 3 days from now, 4 days from now, that this can break through and that can manifest, not just for me and for you, but for the whole humanity, that this breakthrough happened very fast, because the light is coming back and it's coming fast. And let's be part of the light. Okay, so that's my insights. I apologize. I said a couple times dark moon instead of full moon, but it's full moon. So if you like the moon reading, please like it and share it. And I see you maybe for the next half moon. I will see how it goes. And I wish you a very, very beautiful Easter Sunday. And arising from the dead on all levels. Thank you.